us direction from above. We need a word from the Lord.
It's a good thing.
All right.
Word. Many times those kinds of storms just have the appearance of being something that's ugly.
We'll move all the doubt.
But through it all,
and
at the end, you can see the way God sees us.
And give us peace.
Good that I was afflicted.
That's the word, man.
It was good. And in this text, we see that this young boy called a boy, that he was good, and that God took him away. And we see that this is probably where the old folk got the term that the good die young. It's not a bad thing to live a short and potent life for the Lord. I'd rather live a short life for the Lord than to live a long life without Him.
All right. Yeah. All right.
I'd rather serve the Lord and really most of the good die young.
Well.
See, Jesus Christ died in my eyes at a very young age, 33.
Yeah.
To me, that's young. It was a young age, but his death would save those who are 43, 53, 63, 73, 93, any age who would humble themselves before the Lord like a child and give their lives to Him.
Well.
Oh, God looked and He thought that there was only one person in this man's family that was good. And He said, I'm going to take that person unto myself. In the same way that Enoch walked with God and then was no more. The fellowship got so good that the Lord took him on away. People, the good die young. The good die young.
Yeah.
The good die young. You have to let that resound in your heart, in your mind, because for us, that's the most tragic thing, is when young people die. But the good die young. Say to your neighbor.
Oh neighbor.
The good.
Die young.
Many times again, we just take this world and live like this world is our home.
Yeah.
I heard one preacher say that we spend most of our time praying to keep Christians out of heaven. Most of our time praying to keep Christians out of heaven. You say, what kind of prayer is that? Well, it's when we get together on somebody's sick bed and we say, Lord, heal them, please, Lord. Heal them. Grandmama could be 93 years old. Lord, heal them. Please heal them. Great grandmama can be 121 years old. Lord, heal her! No, she couldn't really get that age, but just parenthetically. We spend most of our time praying folk out of heaven. Why is that? Everybody wants to go to heaven, but nobody wants to die to get there.
Amen. Well.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello? Everybody wants to get to heaven, but nobody wants to die to get there. Dying is a part of living. And some of our families have never had a death in a very long time. And some of our families have had a death just last year. But whether your family has experienced it or not, that's one thing is for certain. that death does know your family's address.
Amen.
And that we all will die unless we are raptured. Now, I kind of like that better than dying myself. So just let me live long enough to be raptured. I don't want to die, Lord. But death is a part of life.
It is.
And everybody dies. In the hospital this morning, there was a premature baby that died. Somewhere in the world today, a 2-year-old died. Somewhere in the world today, an 11-year-old died. Somewhere in the world today, a 16-year-old died in a car wreck. Somewhere in the world today, an 18-year-old died. Somewhere in the world today, a 21-year-old died. Somewhere in the world today, a 25-year-old died. Somewhere in the world today, a 33-year-old person died. Somewhere in the world today, a 53-year-old died.
Yes.
Somewhere in the world today, a 68-year-old died. Somewhere in the world today, somebody that was 75. Somewhere in the world today, somebody that was 80. Somewhere in the world today, somebody that was 93 died. And guess what? All thought they were too young to die. Many families thought that they were too young to die. But death is a part of life.
It is.
Seems like the older generation had a better handle of this. They used to say, get right, church, and let's go home.
Yeah.
They understood that this world was not their home, that they were just passing through. Every first Sunday we remind you that Jesus is coming again. This world is not our home. And in this world, sometimes parents outlive the children. In this world, sometimes the good die young. And most definitely in this world, the doing, all of us at one time or another is going to have to do this, and that is to mourn.
Amen.
It said in verse 13, all Israel will mourn for him and bury him. He is the only member of your family who will have a proper funeral. All of us will have to do this one day or another. And all of us touched by the lives of those young people who died. God is telling us as a church that we are to mourn. And we are to give those young people a proper burial. We are to mourn. But not as those who have no hope.
Yeah.
Many Christian folk get so spiritual that they tell you that you're not supposed to mourn. No. The Bible tells us that we mourn. But we don't mourn as those who have no hope. That we mourn, but we have to get a grip.
That's it.
We have to get a grip. And dare I say this. Next two funerals, you're going to see some people who are mourning, and they will mourn as though they have no hope.
Another calm on the sea, but what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.